Welcome to WebStylePress. Testimonials are cool. See these testimonials and these are testimonials at a page, and these testimonials are the same testimonials in slider form. These are testimonials that were added from WordPress admin manually. I will link tutorial in description. How about adding legit testimonials or reviews in WordPress that only your customers manage, and you don't have any control over those ratings and testimonials? Before customers buy a product or service, they check reviews, star ratings, and client testimonials for product. Legit, happy, and returning customers leave good reviews on their favorite products. Business recognize power of social proof, social validation, and show customer reviews in their website. It makes a business legit. Go see any business website that is more than a year old. It will have customer reviews or testimonials displayed in sidebar or on a separate page. I use few WordPress plugins that can easily display Google reviews for businesses on a WordPress-based website for free. Google reviews build customers' trust and increase site's SEO. Means search engine optimization. Before I get into these, I will clear that most of these require Google API key from Google Cloud Platform. You will have to enable Google Places API and Google Maps JavaScript API from Google Cloud Platform under a project. Then API key from that project will be used in the plugin settings. Also, Google account that was used to create Google Cloud Platform should be the account using Google My Business that you want to get reviews from. Google Cloud Platform should be authenticated. That means it should have a credit card linked to it in order to use APIs from it. In simple words, your client's Google account that is using Google My Business and Google Cloud Platform will be used. Your client will provide API key, or you will create one for him in his account. You will need Places ID as well. If you don't know how to create Place ID and API key from Google Cloud and Google Maps, I have tutorials for that. I will link those tutorials in the description. This tutorial assumes that I already have Places ID and API key from Google Cloud Platform. Places ID is the ID for the business that you are fetching reviews from. Okay. Number one, widget for Google reviews. Let's go to plugins. This is a website. Add new. Widgets for Google reviews. This one, widgets for Google reviews. Install. Activate. Here's the plugin. Trust index. Connect Google platform. Google Place ID or URL. Okay. Search for Google Place ID finder. And this is Places ID. Find the ID of a particular place. And here is the map. Let's search for a place. I have the address. Okay, so this is the place ID. Just use address and get the place ID. And then you can use it here and hit check button. Okay, it is suggesting a business. That is what I want. Connect to that business. And now we're connected. And now, as you can see, you have got slider, you have got sidebar, you have got list, grid, list. Okay, that is nice. And sidebar. Nice. Slider in a sidebar. Lot of variations here. Slider. grid, badge, amazing, amazing, button, floating, and pop-up. Well, let's use grid. Let's select this one. And now select this style. Let's select this style, or maybe this one. No, this one. This one's good. Let's select this one. Okay, so set up widget. Okay, so here I can filter your rating and then select language and date format. Hide reviews without comments. Hide rating text. Show verified review icon. Show reviewer's photo. Enable mouse over animations. Use site's font. Okay, so save and get the code. Save and hit the save and get the code. And here is the code. So this is the code. This short code is what we have to use in our website, and this is single short code. I cannot create more short codes with this free plugin, but I can use it, right? And let's create a page. Add new page. Let's create a test page. Test page 2. Save draft. And here let's paste this short code, save draft, and let's see this page output for that slider. And as you can see, the testimonials, reviews from Google displayed in a beautiful, beautiful design. And we can go back and select a different style or layout. Let's select slider this time. Slider, and let's select this one. Select, and also I don't want sidebar here, so content layout should be full width. Publish. So select this for this style, and just give me my widget and just save and get the code, and that's it. Code saved, and short code will be same. You get one short code for free version, and our page saved. And now let's refresh this, and here is the slider. And as you can see, these Google reviews are being fetched from Google for a real business and for free. This didn't use API key, but we needed place ID for it, and we used place ID in the plugin. And here's the slider. Here are the reviews. Okay, we have got more plugins to show you. Let's explore more plugins. We will display those widgets or sliders or reviews from Google at this page. This is the page, and Google business reviews. This is the area, the content area. Here we will place our short codes or whatever, and this is the plugins area, and we are adding new plugin. Let's search for Google review. WP Google review slider. It shows a slider and fetches 5 recent reviews from Google. Let's use it. Activate WP Google reviews. Welcome. Okay, get Google reviews. Okay, at the screen, use my API key rather than use default API key. Default API key may not work. See, something is wrong with this Google API key. I will use this one. Use my API key. I have got this API key from Google. and you can see the instructions here how to get API key. And then test this API key, and this is working. So enter, first I will save settings, then I will search for a business here, and it is displaying a business here. Let's select that, and it picked the location or and place ID, and now minimum rating 5, auto fetch reviews, yes, and save settings. After we have saved it, click retrieve reviews. 5 reviews returned from API. Close. Where are the reviews? Reviews, click at reviews list. These are the reviews, and now we will link these reviews or display these reviews in our website. Go to templates, and we haven't created any template. Add new reviews template. Okay, template title. Reviews slider. Choose template type, post, page, and widget area, and template style is here. And we have just one style. Show stars, yes. Show date, yes. Border radius, 0. And number of reviews, 4. How many total rows? 1. And or 1 review. How many per row? 1. We want to show the slider. Display order random, newest. And hide reviews without text, yes. Yes. And let's save template. So get the shortcode for this template. This is for the PHP, this is for the regular content editor, and here we place it. Update. I'm at the local host, by the way. This site is not live, this site is demo, so this can work on localhost as well. And here is the slider and reviews from Google. Okay, so I am removing this. Let's add another plugin, Google Review, Google Reviews widget. Let's check these two out. Widget for Google Reviews. Activate Google widget for Google Reviews. Tool slider, and this is our newly added plugin, widget for Google Reviews settings. Let's go to settings. Settings, the plugin is currently enabled. Okay, and this is our key and short code, place ID. Connect Google Place to show the short code. Okay, this is the place ID, and connect Google. Okay, so place connected, and it gave me a short code. Yeah, and here's the place name, title, pagination 5, character before, read more link, and widget with refresh reviews, hide based on reviews, place by center, and yeah, that's it. So I have got this short code, so copy the short code, and this is our page. Let's paste the short code here and update it. Let's refresh the page. And here are reviews from Google for an actual business displayed in a widget. This can be used in sidebar, and this can be used in a page or anywhere in your website that you prefer. So this was another plugin. And let's take a look at another plugin, one more plugin. add new Google review. We have implemented this plugin and this slider plugin, this one, and we have to check this one now. Reviews and rating Google My Business. Install now. Activate. And after activating, visit the settings area for this reviews and rating Google My Business plugin. Paste Google API key here and Google Place ID here, and then retrieval language should be English. Update frequency, never synchronize, synchronize weekly or weekly. Save changes. Once Google credentials are in place, you can see this area and a preview here. So review limit, you can limit reviews or you can show all reviews here, and then you can basically select the design from here, color scheme and different settings can be changed for the widget. I'll keep it simple. And this is the short code for the widget. And save changes. Short codes. It has got a separate tab for the short codes. Let's see what's in this tab. And we can get several short codes from here. So you can customize this short code as well. But I will keep it simple and use this reviews underscore rating short code and place it here and update it. And I will get similar widget on my page. Saved and refresh the page. And here is the result. So there are many ways, many plugins, and several ways you can display Google reviews in your website. Let us know which plugin do you use or which plugin did you like. Google review. So the API key and place ID that you saw here won't or may not work for you because these were for demo purposes. For you will have to go to Google Cloud Platform and you will have to create your own API key and enable apps under that to make that work for you in your website and in your plugins. So there are many plugins for Google reviews to display Google reviews in your site. You can check these out, but let us know which one did you like most or which plugin do you use that suits your needs. Let us know in comments. Alright, I will share even more powerful plugins in coming videos. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.